Your support here tonight is a testament to the dedication and the resolve of this entire community. I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone who has contributed to our campaign over the last 600 days. Be under no illusion, this protest is working. This protest and our campaign are at the very heart of the political agenda and the civil and the religious liberty demand. Tonight is a foundation upon which any future agreement will succeed to fail. 20 years from the ceasefires, 15 from the Good Friday Agreement, and the communities were quietly making ground and healing divisions built up over generations. Not satisfied with peace, Republicans began the campaign of agitation. This is not simply about the Crumlin Road. It is about Donegal Street, Newton Arch Road, Carrickill, Springfield Road, Armour Road, Dumcree, Dunloy and Rosharkin, and everywhere else the Republican movement have contributed events for their own narrow political purposes. This is not about a community genuine reaction to a parade along a main thoroughfare. The voice of that community is suppressed by competing forces determined to protect their own narrow selfish aims. This is not about lack of respect or refusal to dialogue. How can it be? For over 10 years, the loyal orders and this community have engaged in dialogue. This is not about triumphalism. What is triumphalism? About a dignified, respectful parade by a religious order. This is not about inconvenience. What can be inconvenient about a 5-minute parade on a public holiday? This is not about offence. What can be offensive about a collarette, a band uniform, or an instrument? The Crumlin Road is used by Unionists day and daily, in both directions, and without offence. Yet we are to believe it causes offence when you add a strip of orange cloth. What's this about? Very clearly, and without any question, is a battle of competing IRAs. The couple of Henry Jars along the Crumlin Road from Tavelle Avenue to Hesketh is the latest battleground in the struggle for the hearts and the minds of the violent nationalism. As ever is the case within republicanism, those who attack the Protestants and most will best state their claim to republican sobriety in our doing. This is about sectarianism and hatred and the heart of republicanism. While those warmongers within republicanism continue in their efforts, we will steadfastly continue on the path ahead. A path is guided by British values of freedom and tolerance. This community, along with the loyal orders, have done their very best to reach out to the Catholic community in our going to show the nationalist community has nothing to fear from the Orange tradition. However, the warmongers and the bigots within republicanism, still intent on murder and mayhem, are using threats of intimidation and violence in order to deny us our basic civil and democratic rights. While Sinn Féin might say they no longer agree with the violent republicanism they help create, they certainly don't mind the results. They deviously manipulate and take advantage of this situation by using the threat of republican violence for selfish and narrow gains, both in terms of policing and parading. This injustice is made worse by the political bias of the Parades Commission and those within the government who have surrendered to these violent threats. Law-abiding citizens should not be punished because of those stuck in hatred of the past and who seek to use violence for political purposes. Our message is very clear. Violence should be condemned, not appeased. Delivering on its promises of a sure future for the people of Northern Ireland, both in terms of policy and practice. Sinn Féin cannot have it both ways. Republicans want to share power in the government of Northern Ireland, but don't want to share public road. Sinn Féin talk about rights and equality, but then refuse to extend those rights for equality to the Leganéil brethren. All of us must challenge this selective and self-serving approach to equality. Despite we are portrayed, we are respectful and law-abiding citizens. As a community, we have suffered a relentless wave of abuse and harassment. This has come from within sections of the press and the media, politicians, police, government, commentators, legal professions, academics, and all sorts of other so-called professionals, mocking and belittling us. This community is not only shameful, but it also acts as a justification for those seeking to resow the seeds of conflict. This is an indictment on the system that people have been pushed so far and mistreated so much that their only recourse is civil action. Let it be said, the Leganéil brethren and the bands will return, and it will be the unbreakable will of the community that makes that so. But no resolution can be just or honourable if it's not based on the certainty of civil and democratic rights. Before I finish, I would like to make an announcement in relation to Denver Smith Memorial Parade on Saturday the 28th of March. We hope people will support it the way they have supported Twaddell. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Let them hope.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters. On behalf of the three lodges, I'd like to welcome you all to our regular parade in Twaddell, Ardoyne. Now, as you all know, this is the 600th night of our campaign to be permitted to walk home. 600 nights, that's almost 10 hunger strikes. We'll maybe get a park called after us, you never know. This is a basic human right in any society, the right to walk home. Well, except a society where this government and previous governments as well are determined to pursue a policy of appeasement that would have embarrassed Neville Chamberlain. I use the word appeasement deliberately because that is exactly what it is. Although in Shinner language, it is peace process. Say or do anything they don't like, and it's an attack on the peace process. Other words used frequently by Adams, Jellyknight Jarrett, and Squeak McGuinness have taken on a meaning totally at odds with what they really signify. They use words like equality, neutrality, shared future, shared space, compromise. All good, decent, positive words which have been corrupted by these people. Nor Sinn Féin, or their real name, the BNP, the Brass Neck Party, are complaining about their so-called dissident colleagues. with McGuinness and others asking, who would do these things? Who would endanger innocent people? Who would carry out murderous attacks? Who would plant bombs? Who would attack people for having a different view? Who would do these things? Well, Martin, next time you're at your RDS, have a good look around the room, then you'll see exactly who would do those things. St. Jerry gave the game away recently when he described his campaign for equality as a Trojan horse to crush those who disagree with him. For Jerry, equality means hatred, bigotry and intolerance. Republicans are not interested in genuine equality or a shared future. Their aim is big old totalitarian and fascist groups, the total destruction of anything that is not Republican. It's our turn at the minute. And if they get their way, then everyone who is not a Republican bigot will have to be aware that their turn will come. As the Lutheran pastor Martin Dean will have said regarding another fascist organization, first they came for the socialists, and I did not speak out because I was not a socialist. Then they came for the trade unionists, and I did not speak out because I was not a trade unionist. Then they came for the Jews, and I did not speak out because I was not a Jew. Then they came for me, and there was no one left to speak for me. Those who support all the unionist parties and groups, those who vote Alliance, even those who vote SDLP, those who vote for no one, remember these words. Anything that is not Republican must be destroyed. Of course, like the Nazis, Sinn Féin are prepared to tell any lies, corrupt any cause, take any action up to and including mass murder to force their agenda on the people of Ireland, North and South. The latest lie in a long litany of lies, and I could go on all night repeating the mantra to speech credit, is a poor wee deer across the road who was so traumatised by the camp that she had to go on the nerve tablets and went to court. Only for the court to hear that she was on nerve tablets after being implicated in a glass bomb attack in 2013. They should not realise the only violence associated with the camp are the attacks emanating from our own community, on the camp. We should not realise that the camp is on a piece of waste ground in a Protestant area. Ground that is only waste because her community attacked the houses that were here so frequently that they had to be knocked down. Hundreds of attacks on Protestant homes, residents and school children over the years don't traumatise her. But a peaceful camp over 100 yards away from our hometown. The level of hatred and bigotry directed towards the unionist community is sad and pathetic. The ludicrous lies they tell to justify that hatred and bigotry is even more sad and pathetic. The willingness of the government, the media and the Parades Commission to give credence to those lies is even more sad and pathetic. Yet that is what we are up against. Years ago, as part of the aforementioned appeasement policy, Republicans demanded and got an official rubber stamp to promote their anti-democratic agenda, and they got it in the Parades Commission. But this is an anti-unionist body was proved many times over. The IRA man who might lose an eye across McLean should hopefully lose his other one as well. PSN as an inspector. He's Catholic and he's blind, he would be a shoo-in. At least the one who in Castle Derrick who saw no breach of the determination should use that as an excuse. There is absolutely no chance of provisional being charged with anything. Even fuel laundering, they're above the law. Just look at Mr. Adams. In an attempt to give him a softer, more human image, I could you not. He claims that he likes to get naked on the bouncy castle with his dog. I feel sorry for the dog. After all, the Adams family and perversion go together with the arm and the backpacks. Can't call him a bird-faced liar because he's a beard. But maybe we can call him a bird hustler. Well, our friends over here, arrest Jerry for cruelty to animals? Of course not. Paddy's heroes are too busy looking for young Protestants. We may try and play a flute in the old place. As we know, they are looking at excuses to arrest young lads for nothing. So don't give them an excuse. Thank you very much for coming here tonight to support our campaign to walk home. Your presence is much appreciated, and I hope to see you, or rather, I hope not to see you again, because maybe this government will go up for it and do the right thing. In the meantime, I would ask you all to go home in your normal, peaceful and dignified manner. Don't give our enemies any excuses, whether Republican, police or government. Let them continue to tell their scurrilous lies. That way we know they're hidden. They tell us to go home. As an Irish man, that's all I want to do. Go home. Thank you once again, and no surrender.